I guess early is better than late, right? Right? But isn't it better? Or no? Or yeah. Whichever. What's up, guys? I'm Erica, and this is Artist Till Death, and we go live every day. Usually. Usually at 6 p.m. Central. If we're on Tuesdays, it's usually 2 p.m. Central. Almost at 3. Anyways, we always do art. It's usually resin. Sometimes it's other forms of art. But today, it is resin. I'm going to try to do another smush. The other two turned out super awesome. I don't have them over here. I'll show them to you, like, later in the show. But they turned out pretty great. So I'm going to try it again on a round. Or two rounds. So, yes. Stay tuned for that. So, what's up? Did you guys see RK3's video yesterday? It was their 25th anniversary. So excited for them. Ron and Kenny are great. If you like to do faux finishes, make sure you check out their channel. Hey, hi, Jenny, Pamela, TG, Kim, Shelly. What's up, y'all? I'm gonna try to do another smush today. I'm gonna try. I've already pre-opened my jars of pigment so that there's no struggle bus. Well, there's probably always some struggle bus, but hopefully it won't be too evident. I went ahead and mixed my resin so you don't have to sit around and watch for that. TG, I can't remember. Are you coming down soon or am I shipping you your pieces? I can't remember. I know we said different things at different times. Just let me know what you want me to do. Or if you're on your way, because that'd be cool too. How's everybody doing? Are you having an awesome Wednesday? I forgot what day it was until I went live. Which is my life most every day. But I'm okay with it. Okay. I don't know if you guys caught my live from yesterday, but the smush we did was a whole lot of fun, and I'm hoping to get a whole lot of fun out of today. We'll see. Of course, Ma'am is in the shadows. I think she's helping Judy again today with some organizing. The colors we're using today is Color Obsession Dark Turquoise, because it's what dreams are made out of. I'm using a titanium white. I'm using Kimmy Shimmer and Bright Gold from Just Resin. This is going to be amazing. Let's get on with it. That's super awesome, TG, and I'm so excited about that. And sounds good. Yes, more smush smush. Okay. So, I'm not gonna forget any colors today because I have them all laid out pretty close to me. We have a dark turquoise from Color Obsession. Titanium white, a Kimmy Shimmer, and a gold. Sadly, the goal didn't show up as much as I wanted it to on the last one, so y'all don't let me skip on the goal. Okay? What are you making Christmas MG with? Oh, what are you, what am I mixing with? A stir stick. An ATD stir stick. Is that your question? Well, thank you, Susan. I got prettied up just for you guys. I don't know if you know this, but I wake up, start putting orders out, answering questions, doing inventory, etc. until it's time to come online. So I literally never go anywhere.
It's true.
It's true. Hi, Lisa. Or medium. Oh, I'm using resin. Epoxy for the win. So a lot of people do swooshes, balloon squishes, or balloon kisses, something like that, with acrylics, but I'm using resin. Anytime I can get away with using resin, I'm going to use resin, because it just works better for me. I'm mixing up too much. I'm mixing up two dark turquoises. This color is slightly translucent, which means you can just barely see through it, which is awesome because it's almost opaque, but if you wanted to add some sparkle to it, like a Milky Way or diamond dust or something like that, abalone, you can, and it'll sparkle like it was meant to be there. So I love having some translucence in my repertoire. What's up, Sue? How are things over in Australia? Hey, Betty. What's up, Joe? You weren't late. I'm actually early. Thank you, Pamela, for the reminder to hit the like button. Okie dokie. Next, we're going to mix up some Just Resin Bright Gold. This is a color, I think, okay. So, I mean, look at this. This color needs to be in everybody's arsenal. It's literally molten bright gold. It's so decadent. Just... can you even? You can't even. No one can even. If I can't even, you can't even. Decadent is such a word for like desserts, but I'm telling you. I mean, you gotta evaluate it, but don't do that. I'm just kidding. Don't do that. I have to say, don't do that. People sometimes will do that, so don't do that. Jen, how are you doing? We've missed you and we love you. I have tried their pale gold. It is also gorgeous. It's like a rustic kind of gold. I usually stick with the bright gold because I like a more abrasive, not abrasive. It's just a brighter. It's a brighter gold. Sorry. Jen, we love that you're here. How are you doing? Black color is acrylic. Nilu? I'm not sure I understand the question. Oh, this. This is actually dark turquoise, and it is all... I'm using all resin and resin pigments today. So I'm also going to use Kimmy's Shimmer. This is going to give me some really awesome cells. This is what would be referred to as cell activator in the acrylic world, but we're in resin world, so it's a base tint. What's up, Tiffany? It's a great soft blue color, and I think it'll accent that dark turquoise. Really, really. really nicely. Everything I'm using is opaque except for the dark turquoise, because it's translucent. So I mixed up 10 ounces for 2 15-inch rounds. Should be plenty enough. Hello, Trisha. Thank you for hitting the like button. If you guys haven't subscribed yet, I mean, you're here anyways. You may as well subscribe, right? That's such an awesome soft blue color. Yes. And now I'm going to use titanium-based white. Because reasons. Pigments to be opaque. Arguably, I add more pigment than I should into my resin, but it's okay because unlike if you added a water-based pigment to your resin, it could set it off early. However, you don't really have to worry about that as much if you use a pigment that's made for resin. A little bit more, it's more forgiving. Gravity. Ooh, I'm using pigment pastes. What's that, Vinny? Bowie, it's okay. It was just gravity. I know, it was just gravity. So, let's get spotted. I'm gonna put a new this on because I'm using a white background. I meant to make two whites and not two dark turquoises. Trisha, thank you. Somewhere. I appreciate that so much. Everything donated to the channel, every payment to the channel, and it really helps us. That's what she said, button. I'm not even sure where that is. It's here somewhere. I will find it and bring it back out just for you, Jen. So the light blue is Kimmy Shimmer from Color Passion. White. So this piece is going to have more of that dark turquoise in it than I originally was going to do, but it's perfectly fine. Perfectly fine. So this is one of our rimmed canvases. So it has this outside bit, the inside, and then it has like a moat crevice. Words as a shallow point between the rim and the main area of the canvas, and that's going to catch any like overflow of epoxy in theory. If I get any resin on that outside area, it's perfectly fine. I'll just wipe it off before it sets up, and then after it cures, I'll have to sand it down anyways. So I will do that in post-production. Now, this application's going to get really rough. It's not going to be that cute, but the end result is going to be worth the hot mess. Okay? It's going to be a hot mess success kind of piece. Right?
Right.
Joe, what's up, Tim? This light blue color is Kimmy Shimmer, and it is by Color Passion. Okay. So, I wasn't going to put this much of the dark turquoise on, but I have to. This does look kind of Pollock-esque. Just hear me out, work with me. It's going to look amazing. And then in the one I did the other day, the gold kind of got lost, so I'm trying to add a little bit more gold than we got last time. All right, I'm going to take this and put it on our other 15-inch round. I'm so excited to see how this is going to turn out. Yeah, I may need to use you in a minute. So don't get comfy. So I've been doing smushes for a bit now with coasters, and I wanted to scale that up a bit, so that's what we're doing right now. Do you have gray in there, or is that a shadow? Oh, it's a shadow. I don't have any gray in there. So I guess I'm going to add some of this to over here as well. Looks like a hot mess. I know. I know this. We know this. But it's going to be amazing.
Oh, you did the camera, didn't you? Look at
it. It was like fine before the sun was setting.
This is like so. You guys.
Tell him it was fine.
Like,
I know, but you want some gloves? No, you don't need them. It's a rim canvas. So I'm using a little bit of heat so that I didn't do that camera. I did the other one. Let me check the other ones and it'll be adjusted. Also, don't lecture me. You know I don't know how to do the cameras, so.
You said you did, so you'd say.
I did. Look how it's not regular. I did. So, I'm gonna need your help. Do you want gloves or you're fine because it's a rim canvas?
What does that have to do with anything?
So
you don't think that's gonna go over onto the other one?
Onto the rim?
Yeah.
Why are you going onto the rim? Do you want gloves? Okay. So we went ahead and added a little bit of heat. I don't want to add too much because all it's supposed to do is make it a little bit more fluid because it's kind of chilly here today. Are you ready? I'm not ready. I'm ready. Okay, here we go. Little bit. Make sure we have contact everywhere.
Oh, I'm so nervous.
Okay, so now I'm gonna do a quarter turn or a half turn?
Do a big turn.
All right, we'll do half. Do you want to pull the top or hold the bottom? Okay, y'all ready? Mommy. Why is it so much difficult? like Christmas morning every time. Let's put some heat on it and see what's happening. I don't understand that little area. Alright, let's inspect this one first. So, once this piece is done, I'm gonna... I'll be redoing the rim of the piece. I'll sand it down and paint it. So this little bit of does. Bee, will you paint a peacock over here?
It's a peacock already.
I want it, do you mind? It does. Beautiful peacock boar. Alright, let's check out. Huh? Let's check out part two. This is the one I got all the resin in the moat. I'm just tilting it so that my moat resin kind of evens out. It's kind of all in this front area. And it should be even. It would self-level on its own, but I'm just helping it get there. I think I like the other one better. This one's kind of sporadic. It's got a lot going on, doesn't it? Thank you, Art by Sparkle. I definitely like the colors too. Better in person than it does on camera. These types of pores always remind me of like a Rorschach test. Words are hard. You know what I mean. Just kind of trying to tilt it around to get a little bit of extra movement. What's up, Steph? B, your nephew's here. I really like this bit. These dark color accents right here. Someone dancing around a fire. You could see that. Go this way. All right. You did do your desktop like that. The gold looks great. The blues look great. Just like this bit the best. I'm sad that it's just only on that corner. Joe, it may amber a little bit. It really depends on a whole bunch of the factors that I went over the other day. However, I will tell you that it won't as bad or as fast as anything else that I've used. Keep the other one that way. I needed this. Let's see if I can add. trying to accent some of these colors that are already here. Well, thank you, Christy. I was hoping that it made sense to people and I wasn't just bumbling around a whole bunch of words. And I was hoping that I wasn't being distracting with all my little edits. I really appreciate that feedback. See, that just looks like a whole bunch of mermaid tails. Gold foil flakes? Like, in it? Swipes of color. We're gonna hope for the best. Thank you, Julia. I'm trying to wipe off my palette knife after each go. Because as I'm applying color, it's picking up color. And if I put it back down, it's just going to be a muddy mess of color. Steph says, hello everyone in chat. Hope you're all having a wonderful time watching these two amazing artists. Make sure to like this video and others. Hashtag family. If you guys don't know, Steph is Jess' nephew, my in a minute nephew. Also, very talented person. Agreed, Evelyn. You're starting to look like a good koi fish. I need to be more confident in these swipes because right now I'm very smooth with them. Video. Just trying to make this make sense before I leave you guys. I think it's coming along. You guys try to do this, make sure you rotate your piece every once in a while so all your palette knife strokes aren't kind of flowing the same. You want to have some differentiation in your movement. Also, whatever rag you're using, don't be attached to it because it will never be the same. Mm-hmm. looks like lotus flower. Jeff, you remember the circular glyph styles you did? Could you do this as a background and color of your choosing to the text? Just a thought. It could. It just would have to be a really dark background. The way this dark turquoise interacts with the gold is probably one of my favorite looks. If it'll focus. Because it's translucent, you can see things behind it, and it's Steph says hi.
Oh, what's up?
What's up, Robin? Thank you, Steph. There really is a lot more detail that it's kind of hard to see. But I will give you guys a little bit of just this. Again. I think with a nice frame on this, this piece will be something else. Try to start using more palette knife moves in my work, but I'm not that skilled with it yet. Whenever I would watch Bob Ross do stuff with a palette knife, I would try to replicate it somewhere. If you do this at home, make sure you don't have a lot of heat on when you do this. And don't use a lot of heat as I'm gonna put this heat down. Don't use a lot of heat because when your resin is thinner, it's gonna be more likely to just mix and combine colors instead of just move and flow over each other. Yes. Sorry, you guys. I got curious about what it would look like if I tilted it some. Tilting it to me just makes things flow more cohesively. It's your prerogative. Actually, in retrospect, I don't want to do that too much because I want to have some like very rustic looking swipe overs. I wish this would focus for you guys. No I'm just gonna manually focus it. You ready? I'm not ready. Hold on. Okay. It's a lot of movement. It's really busy for my work, but it's nice. Also, the dark turquoise here doesn't look like the dark turquoise in real life. Dark turquoise IRL, a little bit more green in it. Also, here is the peacock one. This will be the victory of today's pieces. But if I tried, I could make it look like a peacock for real, for real. Anyways, I'm gonna take these over to the dust-free zone, and I'll be right back. Okay. I'm gonna leave you guys with Bowie. Don't let him take any shots. Well-behaved. You guys didn't let him take any shots, did you? He is quite the party animal. And I'll blame all of you guys. Hey, Clara. Welcome back. Thank you, guys. Sorry for the noise. It's going to be really annoying for just a minute. You ready? Julie, there will be a replay. I may have to rename it to something about a peacock. Still a little bit blue. It's really more turquoisey. That color. Thank you, Evelyn. Alright, guys. What would you like to see on tomorrow's live? Open for suggestions. I have a couple things I need to review. Is there a technique you guys want to see? It's just, it's forever there, I feel like. Forever. JJ, anytime. Coming through to visit. So if you guys have any suggestions of what you want to see tomorrow, comment down in the description box. I'll review those at about 4 before I go live. I know, it's horrible. Anyways, if you guys don't know, this is my Bobo. The dim big boy lion. He's in big boy lion. Did you get a haircut yesterday? Are you the fluffiest one? I should put up a Bowie cam so you guys can see how awesome he is all day every day. Anyways, different types of substrates you guys offer. I can do a video on that. Super easy. Patina on the rims of the piece you just did. That is a beautiful idea. Is there a schedule for your lives or are they always different? Julie, I accidentally went live early today. On purpose. You know, there's just a break in my day sometimes where I'm like, I'm inspired to do this right now. And so on those moments, I go live early. Typically, usually 90% of the time, we will be here at 6 p.m. Central, which would be 22 minutes ago, wherever you are. Except for on Tuesdays, it's at 2 p.m. Central. Be everyone so bless you. He's reorganizing his vinyl area, so he's kicking up some dirt. Not dirt. Dust. Allergens. Anyways. I try to comment in the ATD's group. So you can see when we are gonna go live, if we're early. Anyways, we love you guys so much. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. If you think you're already subscribed, please double check, because YouTube likes to unsub people, because rude. And yes, if you have any other questions, comment down below. Check out our other videos. Share one of our videos if you could, because it helps our channel super much. You can find all the things that we use today on our website, artisttilldeath.com. Look for one of these. And Roll Tide Lisa. Yeah. Be kind to one another, because you never know what someone's going through.
And always remember, we do the test,
so you don't have to! That was a little bit less. Awesome than it usually is, but still applies. Are you guys, you are amazing. Judy, I know you have the most organized studio. Rub it in. You had Vamp for the last like month, I'm pretty sure. Anyways, we are at about 51,000 subscribers, which is bananas.
We are at 51,000.
Oh, sorry, we are at 51,000. Anyways. See you guys tomorrow. Bye.
I said bye.
To the outro. Big Bowie and Big Bowie a bean.
You still smell pretty good.
The smelliest, goodest one.